Oh shit, we're recording?
Yeah, yes, that's good.
Oh jeez, alright. Hey guys, welcome to the first Kazamatsuri podcast in a while. We're just kind of here to chew the fat, talk some shit, and just like, basically have a conversation about what's going on with Ki right now, because I feel like it's kind of a very confusing time, lots and lots of shit going on, and I want to like try and set the record straight on some things and hopefully like get some discussion happening about where we think Key's headed in the future. So joining me this week we have myself and Spidey along with Biscuit there.
What up?
It's been a while since you've been in our podcast, so it's good to have you back.
Yeah, something like that.
Helios Alpha, this is your first time on our podcast. Welcome aboard.
Hello. Helios Alpha, I do a bunch of translations on the forums, I guess that's what I'm known that's for.
You're the man.
You're also known for always being in the chat.
Yeah.
that as well. I've practically been on podcasts before, just through the chat.
Helios is actually the secret puppet master of Kazamatsuri, behind the scenes of everything.
I thought that was Hyrian.
He's a secret admin.
But Helios, like, Helios is a ghostwriter of all our articles.
Oh, okay. So that's who sends me the information?
Yeah.
I'm also, as far as I know, the only forum member who's read every Ki work, for better or worse.
every Ki visual novel.
But Nishizono's Lock Murder Room mystery thing.
Yeah, have you read that, Helios?
Read that.
We don't. No, damn. I haven't. Shh, Pepe, shh.
Have you read the rewrite Chihaya Lucia Idol BN?
No.
How quickly you've fallen from grace.
You gotta get working on that.
They don't count. They're like anime specials.
Anime doesn't count. You heard it here first.
Wow.
Read the VN.org.
So Pepe, you're also here.
What's up?
Hey,
I'm
Pepe.
Here to talk shit about Ki.
Speaking of anime, it feels like Ki has kind of become an anime studio all of a sudden.
In a sense, well, I guess.
I would say maybe not really, but kind of.
I don't know, man. It's all these animes popping up all of a sudden. We have Charlotte happened a while back, which was a completely anime original. Then we're getting the rewrite anime. Yeah. Freaking Kudwafter anime's been announced. We had the amazing Planetarian anime. And for all we know, there's going to be a Summer Pockets anime, too.
Where's my Tomoyo After sure anime?
Where's Tomoyo After?
Yeah, good question. Where is the Tomoyo After
what
anime?
What the hell, Ki? Why Kudwafter and not Tomoyo After?
Bad choice.
I'm guessing...
Because they want to
make
money.
Okay, I can see two reasons why they might have done that. The first being that they already have JC staff worked on Little Busters. They can probably get them to do Kudwafter. On the other hand, Tomoyo After, like, getting Kyoani to do that is, like, impossible. So maybe they're a bit... more resistant to like bringing back Clannad with a new studio, they feel like.
And of course, naturally, yeah. If you brought that in, and then you had, you know, the Kiyawani crew comes in, they're just like, oh, this is gonna be bad because it's not the Kiyawani. So like, it's immediately going to be.
I look at what Kiyawani's animating this season. I just shake my head, but anyway.
And there's also the lolicons.
Unless you like the
wouldn't necessarily have to Lollies be Q&A, because the art was different.
Actually, yeah, that is true. But, well, the fans will expect, you know how it is. Yeah.
You know how Ki fans are. Those Ki fans, always being so entitled.
Damn.
I still don't really see Yarian around very often, but I'm pretty sure that he's to blame for all of this, because I'm pretty sure Ki saw the Delicious Lolly video, and they know what the Ki fans really want.
Yeah.
He was also the one who made the article about the Kudwafter getting an anime.
Yep.
The April Fool's article. Why am I peeking so much? I'm so far from the microphone.
His premonition. But yes, so we're here to talk about Ki, and yes, they have announced that they are making plans to make a Kudwafter anime. So what do you guys honestly think about
this? This is truly the worst timeline.
We're in the timeline that got abandoned.
Yeah.
I mean, We don't lose anything, do we?
I don't know.
Do we lose anything?
No.
I mean, we'll probably just get a slice of life that maybe somehow...
I'm honestly just salty that it's not Tomoyo after. Sure, we don't lose anything, but... Yeah.
You don't gain anything.
Yeah, you don't get anything either.
Just because we're getting a Kudafta anime doesn't mean that we would have gotten a Tomoyo after anime otherwise.
Helios! No, what do you think of Kudwafta as the only person here who's actually read it?
I think it's, first of all, like, a lot of people compare it to Tomoya After because they're like, oh, they're both spin-off games, but the comparison could not be further off. It's, Tomoya After is quite amazing and Kudwafta is absolute horseshit.
Damn!
Very blunt. Classic Helios Alpha style.
Yeah. It's even like it's not even the reputation of just being lolly porn, which there is quite a lot of, but most of it is just extremely boring slice of life.
Would it be better as an anime?
I don't know, is a cooking show with Kud funny?
I could definitely argue that there are some VNs that I've read after seeing the anime version, and like, there definitely are some anime adaptations that take a lot of liberties to change something that kind of has a bulk of content that doesn't necessarily fit in an anime setting, and then they actually make it better. The only thing that actually comes to mind being Shuffle, actually, was an anime that I quite enjoyed.
Yes, very much so.
Quite enjoyed a lot.
And the VN was horrible, by the way.
So I wouldn't say it's, you know, it's non-zero possibility that something good could come out of it, but...
I'm still in the camp that's like, I reckon that the rewrite anime can make Terror, like, not a horrible mess. I reckon they can improve Terror, but that's being optimistic, I know, considering they don't have the best track record.
Lots of opinions going around, obviously. We don't
know
for sure.
There are people who genuinely enjoy anime about cute girls serving coffee, and if there are people who enjoy that, I'm not the kind of person who enjoys that, but there's a market for it.
Mm-hmm. I know there is drama in Kudwafta Helios. Is it at all going to redeem it?
I mean, in the sense of like a one core series, I actually don't even think it would be one core. I wrote on the forums that I think they're probably going with like a web based thing, like Planetarian, because they get a lot more like room to move in terms of time.
They could just literally make it a hentai.
I mean, if you look
they can do that
if
too.
You look at the two sides of their animes that are like kind of different studios and everything, obviously being something in consideration. If you look at Planetarian and Rewrite, which came out pretty much side by side, but through completely different means, it's clear which one was, you know, everyone liked, and the one that is very not necessarily as liked. you would think that as a business, Key would look at those two things and see which is a higher quality product, and then see what kind of method they want to then use going forward for some of their shorter stories.
Sure.
But I really feel like Planetarian probably hasn't sold that well because it was a net anime, which is really depressing, because that series was fucking amazing, guys.
We don't know how well it sold, I haven't gotten the solid numbers, and
the only like first of all, the sales figures on anime is really inaccurate.
Right.
I would take anything.
They can like, boost sales by including like a ticket to a concert or something. Instant sales.
That too, but there's also just the, I don't remember what the site is called, but like the, just where they get the numbers from is like, they only take them from one source and stuff. Like, there was something, like, recently about Flip Flappers being released and how it was written as having sold, like, 600 units or something. Mm. but then it had sold apparently like a couple of thousand on Amazon, and like I don't know what the fuck was going on there. So numbers are weird and very rarely accurate.
Yeah, and plus the Hoshinohito Blu-ray isn't even out yet, and I think that is the crowning glory of the Planetarian anime. Like, you don't even have to watch the web anime, because you can just go straight to Hoshinohito.
Yeah, it's interesting how they designed that to be like standalone almost. Yeah. They designed Hoshinohito to be a standalone experience. And as far as I'm aware, like, it really was a hit in Japan. Like, I'm pretty sure I've seen that.
I saw lots of good talk about Planetarian itself, even just as, like, a web series and stuff. Like, people talking about how it's, like, that it was really brilliantly marketed and that it was a really good idea and stuff. And then on the same side, I saw a lot of people who actually went out to see that movie and said it was really, really good.
Unfortunately, it got drowned in by the hype of
Kimi no Nawa. Koi no Katachi.
Koi no Katachi actually wasn't as hyped as you would think. Like, there were only a few cinemas that showed it, surprisingly. But yes, it was competing with the Koi no.
It's unfortunate timing, I guess.
It's a good year for anime movies.
So, I guess moving off the topic from anime, kind of an elephant in the room we need to address is Maeda-san. What's going on with Jun Maeda? Because
he's alive.
He isn't dead, despite popular knowledge. I think who's more qualified to talk about this? I think Helios knows a lot about Maeda's situation.
Oh god. Well, honestly, no one really knows. I think. What we do know is that he made a Twitter account, and then, like, randomly around, like, February last year, he tweeted, "Oh, I'm gonna be hospitalized." And then we heard nothing for, like, 9 months.
Kind of a big 180 on that Twitter account. Because that Twitter account started as, he made it very clear, "Oh, I'm just making this account to talk about Mahjong," because he's playing a lot of Mahjong at the time.
Yeah.
And then, it just, like, flipped the other way, and now he just kind of talks about whatever on it.
Yeah,
he's become very active. Like, he talks a lot about music nowadays.
But yeah, he did tweet that the operation or whatever was successful, didn't he?
Yeah. And so far,
otherwise he would be dead at this point.
Yeah.
Probably.
Did they ever say what the condition was? I feel like they did.
Yes, they did.
They gave some long name for the heart disease. I don't remember. It was something.
It was some form
that
of arrhythmia.
Requires a heart transplant, but he currently is alive. He has not received a transplant, but he's not dying in the near future.
He hasn't received the transplant yet. I thought he was done with the transplant.
I believe it said that operation. He is on a list. Is that a thing? I can't remember.
Yeah, something along the lines of cardiomyopathy.
I don't remember anything like that.
Yeah.
I believe the idea is that I've seen photos of him in rehab. So, like, he's obviously gone through a lot, but he's on the road to recovery, like, making regular check-ins with the doctor. But I don't know. Like, there's some weird stuff going on, because he said that he's having, like, trouble composing music now. It's like,
not composing, just
singing. He specifically said singing.
Yeah. Okay, singing. My bad.
Autumn Song, he said when Autumn Song came out, he said that it was something that he wanted to sing himself, but he made it pretty clear that he just couldn't. He's like, nah, I can't do that, so we got someone else to do it.
He can't do it anymore.
Probably both
and
physically
that just means
and
that
mentally.
We're not going to get a second Hikikimori Naruto. No. But he's working on a new album right now, so obviously he's not.
I do like
out
his
of
singing
being.
Love
voice
Song 3, boys! Woo!
Love Song 3.
Hey, alright, Love Song 3.
What yeah, do I don't know, think? Like, with that news comes questions about, like, the status of Angel Beats, doesn't it?
It's fucking dead.
First Beat came out. From everyone I've talked to, I think Helios can probably attest to this. It was good, yeah. You thought it was good, Helios?
I think so. as a prologue to the Angel Beats saga, yes, yeah. It's cool.
And it sold terribly despite that. Maybe it didn't do so well in Japan.
I believe the general consensus was like, some of the stuff didn't really add enough, but some stuff added a whole lot, but then in the end it just kind of left everyone wanting more, which could be, I guess, considered a good or a bad thing. A good thing in that it was good enough to where people want more, like, because it was a good start for what could come, but then bad because there might not be more to come.
I'm guessing the main reason for that would be low sales, which is probably more due to the declining visual novel industry than to anything about the game itself. That's my opinion, anyway. And yeah,
when Angel Beats first started to like become a thing, I had the opinion that I felt like it really needed to, and that it had a lot of opportunity to kind of change the medium quite a bit and like create something really, really big to try to bring those kind of sales back, and that it needed to do something like that to kind of place itself in there and to boost those sales. But I felt like it, I guess it just didn't, like, it didn't change enough.
Yeah.
Despite the amount of work that they put into it, and I think that probably hurt.
P.S. Join the Love Song Book Club, guys.
And then on the flip side of that, they also, you know, had animes coming out at the time, so Charlotte became a thing, and I kind of, again, I'm just of the opinion that it looks a lot like Key as a business is starting to look towards other mediums to like for success and for ease of consumption. Like, it's much easier for groups to watch animes than it is for people to get into VNs. Like, there's less of a barrier in the way by creating animes than there is making a VN, because with making a VN, not only do you need to try to move that medium forward, but you also need to still bring people in to begin with.
Yeah, so Heaven's Door ended recently, Angel Beats Heaven's Door. And we thought that would have been the end of it. But then all of a sudden, they announced a new Angel Beats manga. What was it called again?
We don't know anything yet.
Yeah.
Like,
no, the name.
They literally just said, like, oh, something else is coming 2017. Okay. And we haven't heard anything like that. They called it, like, it wasn't a title, but they called it, like, the true, something like true form of Angel Beats,
true root,
or something like that.
The Angel Beats that he always wanted to write.
Nah.
Which implies that Maeda is working on it.
He definitely
the,
is.
It said he's the writer. It still has Asami Yuriko as the illustrator and everything.
Yeah. The Angel Beats that will actually come out.
Like,
good choices.
Pretty good way to put it.
Yeah, it's basically like the two people who worked on Heaven's Door, and might be more, but like the Heaven's Door, but the actual story,
it's a sequel
of
to Heaven's Door.
It's the sequel to Heaven's Door, and it kind of sounds like a VN probably isn't going to be a thing, so we're gonna take all of this content and create the expanded true root. Like, for example, the anime you could consider to be, like, the main root of Angel Beats, but, like, you know, actually fleshed out.
Yeah.
Is kind of what it sounds like.
Yeah, I'm thinking so as well. So, interested to see how that goes, but also kind of, like, I really would like Second Beat. Especially considering that an English localization is on the horizon. Now,
that could very easily be something that's been scrapped already, because that was a decent ways away. That was a while ago, probably before that was before, you know, Heaven's Door had a conclusion and they've announced this new project. So I wouldn't be surprised if, because it was business terms. They said there are plans to do this, but that doesn't necessarily mean that those plans are in motion. So that could have been something that they wanted to do.
Like, that interview was in May, I think. And like, Heaven's Door, like, I'm pretty sure, like, Heaven's Door would have been, like planned and, like, storyboarded, like, way earlier.
I mean, that was, like,
because
a good...
obviously Maeda spent 9 months in the hospital, and there wasn't a break in Heaven's Door at all.
Yeah, alright, so moving on to a different topic. Let's talk about all the stuff changing at Key lately. It's kind of juicy. We have Hinoe Itaru, one of the founding members of Ki, has actually left the company entirely.
Unfortunately.
It was like a few days before Harmonia was released, in fact, which is like her last work for Ki. So it's kind of a little bit sad that she had to leave right before that got released. But yeah, so she's doing her own thing now. I think she's gone freelance. Has she like been contract?
She specified, I believe, that she said she wanted to like do more like sci-fi and like something like a horror novel or something.
Yeah, she did say that.
She wanted to do with her art.
Yeah, she said something about
horror. Which sounds very interesting, and you know, hope the best and all that.
I'm definitely gonna keep
following her.
Yeah, I haven't heard much news. Like, I think. What was
as
that
far
Soldier
as Hinoe's career, yeah. As far as Hinoe's career
is just like things she sold on Comic Yet.
Yeah, an art book, was it?
Or to me, it sounds.
She also had like.
It sounds like. Like the Moe art style kind of thing. The bubbly art style is something that she doesn't want to feel like she's stuck doing forever, and so she's going to take the opportunity to like change it up, I guess.
Yeah, which is probably for the best.
Which is very interesting, very very interesting. I would love to see her come out with some stuff that like changes her formula.
And that's not all. We also have Yuzo Tonokawa, one of the lead writers at Ki, has also left the company, and this happened a lot more incognito. I think it was first announced.
It was first announced in the announcement for Summer Pockets, which we're gonna talk about later. I suppose. It was kind of weird. Like they talk like in this article they mention that he like seemingly dropped from the company like quite a while ago, but then it hadn't gone public at all, and when this article drops, he all at the same time makes a Twitter account and just says, "Yeah, I'm freelance now." By the way,
that's
so,
really depressing.
I don't know,
like,
it's weird.
Yeah, so we've lost the scenario writer of Bunch of Roots and Little Busters and Rewrite. Like obviously, Rewrite was all mostly like it was Romeo and Ryukishi, which aren't part of Ki to begin with, so that's like literally all of the Rewrite staff is gone. Except for Shinji Arata and Maeda.
The tricky part is that he in an interview from the Little Busters like Perfect Visual book, he states that he and Maeda were working a lot more closely than it wasn't just they just assign him a route. He was actually working in particular, he told Maeda his opinions on what Maeda had planned for the ending, and he said it was way too sad, and thanks to that, that's why we have the current ending.
Oh no!
It's Tonokawa's fault!
Tonokawa is the reason it's not enough? Wow.
Yes.
Yes.
Maybe.
Wow.
Maybe.
That's juicy.
Yeah, that's pretty much.
Thanks, Helio.
So, is this a good thing he's left?
Probably something that is quite controversial.
Yes.
My two cents on Tonokawa being that I'm not tremendously surprised by it. I know why he was there. It's because I know that Ki likes to have kind of an open door, kind of revolving thing. Specifically, Baba had specified that he likes new, upcoming, youthful writers with fresh ideas and things like that, which is good.
They got that new writer in for Harmonia too, didn't they?
That's very smart.
They have two new writers. Oh wait, sorry.
Going forward,
no, it's one.
Just one. Sorry.
Nakamura Tsuzuru or something.
But at any rate, I would say that his group of contributions is a lot of hit miss stuff. And the stuff of his that I really liked through time and through reading other stuff, I found to draw quite a lot of parallels to other writings. Probably still the peak being the Kurugai route, which has a little bit of uniqueness in its kind of fairy tale sense. But basically, Tonokawa is very much kind of a Maeda protege in a lot of ways. But in the same sense, it's not deviated enough and not deep enough to like be kind of its own thing, so I don't know.
Hmm.
I don't see him as really that big of a part of Key. He has left, but as you said, Key tends to switch the writers around a lot. He has written more than most.
The probability is that, like, again, maybe he wasn't given enough credit. That's a possibility.
Maeda steals all the credit.
The problem was he never had the chance to actually plan the project or be like the producer of any project.
Yeah, he's always been a side. Maeda did like a side helper. Yeah.
What's his name for Rira?
Which one? Tanaka Romeo.
Romeo Tanaka was the main producer for Rewrite, so he just helped out with that. So we never really got the chance to see what he's like.
Did Tanaka do Angel Beats?
No,
he was not on Angel Beats.
Kai, Leo Kashida.
Leo Kashida, that's the other one, yeah.
And Kai.
Yeah, so moving on from that, we have all of this info recently. If you look at anything Key's making, Kai is at the top of the list of writers. It's just...
Kai and Leo Kashida are, like, both technically not considered in-house Key writers, so... Who is a Key writer at this point is kind of the questionable thing.
Yeah. But,
because they all do different things through visual arts and other things.
Yeah, but then I see, like... If you look at the Rewrite anime, that's directed by Kai, wasn't it? Ignis Memoria is getting a scenario by
Kai. No, it's direct. It's not directed by him, it's directed by
That's the wrong word. Yeah. But it's like, he's like the script supervisor or something?
He helps with the script. But he does that alongside Romeo.
But then Kai isn't there, and he didn't work on the original Rewrite. He's also doing the script for Ignis Memoria, the upcoming social game, which is totally a thing and looks kind of cool. He did Harmonia, he did First Beat, and he's doing Summer Pockets. This guy is all over the place right now. He's doing pretty much everything that comes out of Key. How do you feel about this? How do you feel about the new Kai regime?
I don't think I've read a Kai work that I've disliked, so I am totally all for it. Guy as a writer, and he has had much experience in writing VNs, so I trust him pretty much. And
I think he's good.
I am all for the Kai regime. Hi, look, hi.
And Maeda is basically not involved with Summer Pockets at all, guys. I'm pretty sure they were having like probably a business party, just like having some drinks, and Maeda's like, check this out, guys. Here's my great new idea.
They actually had a competition
for Summer Pockets
at the company.
Yeah,
it was like,
and Maeda wrote something.
Everyone,
what?
Interview. I'm pretty sure I mentioned this when it came out, and you just forgot. they held a competition at Key, and maybe it was like visual arts, other visual arts people involved as well. But, like, people were, like, turning in ideas for what to do. And then Maeda was like, I have an idea. And then everyone was just like, yep, this is the Maeda work. Let's do it.
He won because he's Maeda.
Yeah, it certainly feels
they
like
ended
it.
Up, they ended up not caring about the competition.
But it's...
I think...
I don't know.
They need to get Maeda on it so they can put his name on it, though, guys.
Canon accidentally an opinion in voice real quick, and I want to go ahead and I'm gonna read it out because I agree with it. I think me and Canon are on the same page, is that I don't dislike anything that he's done. It's always been good, but none of it has been, like, great, with the exception of the stuff that he's done together with Maeda, which I can't really pinpoint. Yeah, Kyoru's pretty hit-miss for a lot of people, so I won't say that.
Never mind.
We've been conditioned to expect Key greatness, and it's not something that Kai has really grasped yet, I don't think. But with him leading a project, there is opportunity there. There's potential. So there is the potential that it could be something very great, especially considering it's been birthed from the great Maeda head. So the opportunity is there, and there's nothing wrong with his writing. He's a good writer. So I think that the possibility that Summer Podcast is good exists, and I think that's really important because I guess we could transition towards Summer Podcast in a bit.
Yeah.
I figured that's where you would
go. Yeah. And I guess just to start with that, I kind of want to talk about the position that Key's in and the stuff that they've been releasing. Even though I don't know how they function as a business, I don't know where they really stand. For me personally, I think Summer Pockets is kind of a very pivotal piece where I feel like if it isn't great, then I'm going to be very skeptical, if not just kind of completely without care in regards to Key products at this point. Like, I think they really need to put out something great and something original, and I think that this is their biggest opportunity to do so, and if they don't do it, then they're going to continue to suffer because they're just repeating the same thing over and over again, making lackluster stuff.
See, I think you're being very cynical there, because, like, have they really been releasing...
I admit that I am.
But First Beat wasn't a lackluster product. It was just an incomplete one.
It was too big. It was too big of a project.
Too ambitious. I don't
think it's really going to go anywhere, which again is another benefit to Summer Pockets, because it seems, as of right now, it seems to be a much smaller thing. You've got four characters, right? I think, and then like your main character, that's a very good kind of tight thing that they could do a lot of depth in the writing and make something that's not too overly ambitious, and that they can really hone in on those characters, and they need to not, you know, oversaturate it, and I think that they have a lot of good opportunity here. They have everything in their hands right now, to make something really great. So that if they mess this up, then it brings a lot of questions about the future of the company, because they shouldn't mess this up.
Yeah, sure.
I think it's hard to say that they're starting to go into a stage of mediocrity, because like it's very subjective. Like, what was Key's last quote unquote great thing?
Little Busters.
Many people mark the line on Little Busters. A lot of people still think Rewrite was pretty great, you know? And if we take that line, then that leaves only Angel Beats First Beat.
Little Busters.
And, I mean.
No, Little Busters. Rewrite is very close to being great, but I feel like it has too many weird little Swiss cheese holes in it.
It's still very
Which is why the thing of Rewrite Plus existing.
I consider Rewrite one of the greats. It definitely had enough impact on people.
Rewrite Plus has a lot of opportunity to become something great, but from the sounds of it, it's not.
It had the opportunity and that different. Didn't take it.
I mean, I wouldn't say just because they're making if they make something that isn't quote unquote great, that means that they're spiraling into something.
This is just. I prefaced all this with saying that again. This is just for me personally. Like,
all right, okay.
Like, from my standpoint, I'm at the point where they haven't put anything out that has been solid in quite some time.
But it's also the fact that they haven't done a major vision novel release in quite a while. Mm-hmm. Like, they did First Beat, but that's kind of a weird thing because that's a pre-existing franchise. That's no new ideas.
I haven't read Angel Beats, but it's not
a new concept.
But from what I've heard of it, it's something that I think was hitting all of the right notes, I think, going forward, and that if that had become a complete product, then it probably would be something great, but it's not something that people are taking because it's just too big and too ambitious.
I think if we got another rewrite...
I'll use a very typical business term here in saying that I feel a lot like Summer Pockets has... It's back to roots, I guess, for lack of any other way to put it.
It feels that way.
Very straightforward visual novel. They can't screw this up. Like, it's so, as it is, it's very tight, and I think that they can make something extremely solid, and as long as there's something in there that, like, makes it impactful, then it's going to be good.
Yeah, I wouldn't disagree. It's definitely a pivotal point, because this is Key's next big idea. Not including animes, not counting previous franchises, not counting small visual novels. This is the first one since Rewrite, and that was like 5 years?
If I would compare this VN to anything else, I would say I want it to be like, in terms of its design, I feel like it needs to be like a canon. Like, it needs to just be very, very straightforward and not do anything crazy.
Well, it sounds like it's going to be canon to me. From everything I've heard, it sounds very much like they're going back to the basis of canon there.
Canon in some.
But we don't really know a lot about it. Like, the whole thing with Key Vision Novels is, ever since Air, there's always been this meta-narrative that kind of strings the roots together and really, like, brings that big impact forward. Like, the roots are fine. but there's always something bigger. Ever since Air. And that's kind of become a tradition with Key now, with Air, with Clannad, with Little Buster, with Rewrite.
It's and always, they're becoming always they're, a big something. I think they're getting way too focused on it. And I think that if they keep trying to force that, then they're gonna keep having problems. Like, you need to stop trying to recreate Clannad or recreate the experience of Little Buzzers, because you're not going to do that. You need to make something new. Like, if it happens, it happens. But if it doesn't, don't try to do it, because it's just going to make your ending suck. Like, don't do anything wacky. Just take it easy. You know what I mean?
So, would you be fine with a Summer Pockets that doesn't have any true ending?
That would be cool. Yes, I would enjoy that.
Hmm.
I mean, it could have a main like staple route and everything, but I don't think that it needs to have some crazy twist at the end and have some special new route. Like, I think if they just make a bunch of really solid writing and stuff, then I'd be perfectly content with that.
Okay, I'm kind of like,
it would be a hell of a lot easier for them to do.
I really am wondering where Key will stand on that, because it really does feel like that whole like. That true ending thing is really a staple of Key now. It's kind of a big part of their brand. Going away from that would be a very risky move, but then you could argue that they're being bound to that is restricting them creatively.
And yes.
Yeah, I get that. I don't know. I don't know where I stand this. I just need more info. I don't really know enough about Summer Pockets.
I'm not going to put any expectations into this. I'm just going to expect that they will put out the quality work, which is something I can expect from Key. I don't have any hopes that it'll be any sort of thing that I wish it to be.
Not even a mecha anime?
If they want to make it, even if it is a mecha anime, I just assume that it's going to be a quality work. And so far, everything I've read from them has been quality.
If I can just bring up a tiny point, like regarding the true ending. There's like, from the information we have, you can make like arguments that they're hinting towards like either, like there's hints towards either or, like having a meta, like an overarching narrative, or doing and it like canon, where
without having to like else. Make this super crazy web of stuff that they need to find a way to like make it all connect at one point. They could make a lot of really cool, unique endings, and they could really focus a lot of their time, of course, obviously, into the writing of each individual route and, like, fleshing out each character individually, as well as being able to put a lot of dev time into this, like, kind of exploratory thing that they got going on with this island, and, like, being able to, like, take Mappy or take the choices in Angel Beats to go see different characters and, like, really flesh that out and make something really cool. Where, like, it's a really a cool experience, and it makes you want to read the thing again so you can go, like, do different stuff, and, like, maybe there's some sort of time thing to it where you can go different directions and see different things. I think that's good, and I think that's going to bring that's exactly the kind of thing that's going to advance visual novels into something bigger and better.
I don't know, because I think the problem is the visual novel industry is already saturated with exactly what you said.
You don't know if that's innovative enough for Key to
rip it off. I think exactly what you said is what's happening with a lot of visual novels now, where they are very invested in characters. They make their characters very fleshed out.
Yeah,
they
but are the writing is very much so don't. Not very good. Whereas Key could make really good writing and design.
I mean, there are a lot of visual novels that have very good writing. They are the things that we don't get to read because we're in Japanese.
I guess to wrap things up, we can go ahead and talk about like Key's business practices, kind of like how they've completely shifted from being a company that basically didn't say anything to being a company that's been very vocal
in the past
few years.
And that's improving. Like, even Baba said on his year in review that
significant.
He wants Visualize to be more open. Like, they're going to do more like live streams and stuff, just like talking about stuff.
Yeah. And I'm a huge fan of how much more transparent they are now than they had been. I think that there's definitely room for them to be a little bit more transparent about some things, especially like there's a lot of obvious things, like the fact that they haven't come out and said anything about the state of Angel Beats and stuff like that, where it's starting to be like the elephant in the room. It's kind of an awkward silence that I think someone needs to break the ice and be like, okay, look, here's where we stand with this. I think that's really important. Because as of right now,
silence.
As of right now, you've got a whole lot of people who are standing around with these, you know, giant paperweights that say Angel Beats on them, because that's supposed to be our, you know, our key to the rest of that series, and yet we're apparently not getting anything, and we have a lot of people who spent quite a lot of money on that. As a business, it's going to be kind of a stain on them if they don't come out and clarify some things.
It would be very good if a Angel Beats First Beat localization did come around, though, because I actually do... I am confident that that would sell well. That would sell like hotcakes. People in the West love Angel Beats. They want more. They want a season two.
With them coming out, you know, more openly overseas, I think that that opens up a lot of opportunities for them to actually properly market that as well.
Mm.
Because would it sell? Sure, probably, yes. But only if you market it properly.
Yes, that is very true.
And that, which, and that's exactly what Key is doing.
Yeah, and I think that they're in the right direction for that.
I mean, it's pretty weird the news that they've released recently with Planetarian getting a German release.
Yeah, and Chinese.
I mean, who'd have thought? And Chinese is valid because huge market and everything.
Did they say anything on Clannad being Chinese?
Yes, they did. I know, we report on that.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I didn't. I don't know Chinese, so why would I read that article?
It wasn't. The article wasn't in. Our article wasn't in Chinese.
But yeah.
Anyway.
But anyway, so we can expect Key to continue pushing their overseas involvement, probably with the next batch of overseas events. I wouldn't be surprised if they did in Shanghai and, I don't know, Berlin, where do the events happen?
I know Caselli really wants them to come to Russia, but it might be a while away. Like, I'd love them to come to Australia, but I don't think that's happening.
I'd really like to see... I'd like to see them... Because, like, with Harmonia, it was very interesting how that came to be, and it came out to be really a really nice localization, really good translation and everything. I felt like that was really smooth. But then they had this whole marketing thing where, like, it comes out in the West first was, like, their big thing. And, like, while that's very flattering, I would like to see them try to bring things together on the same ground. Like, I would love to see Summer Pockets come out in English and Japanese at the same time together. Like, that would be very, very smart business decision. I don't know how much work that would be for them and how much more time that would tack on to Summer Pockets release, but they don't have a release window for it yet or anything, so I think that is still something that they can decide as a business, and I think that, considering what they've been doing, I think that that's something that's in their future and also would be something that would greatly contribute to them succeeding.
Mm, I agree. I think simultaneous
It's a very marketing thing. If their marketing powers can handle that, I'm sure it's viable.
Mm.
Like, I'm pretty interested in what they plan to, you know, offer in next year's overseas events. Like, will there be a physical Harmonia release in English? Maybe?
Who knows?
They did it for Planetarian, right?
It's definitely something they don't need to do, but it would be interesting.
They don't need to, but a lot of people would spend money on it.
I'd get it.
They'll probably... Yeah, they'd probably... Yeah, so would I, yeah.
With the exception of,
they'll
like...
probably also sell a lot of rewrite stuff, I guess.
With the exception of fan service products being, you know, what they are, I think Key has done a lot of work to, like... Everything they do seems from the heart to me still. Like, I still feel like a lot of the stuff that they do for their fans. I think that they care very just deeply, like, about their fans, and I think that's just kind of the person that Baba is. Like, I don't see him as a cold businessman. I see him as a really cool guy who cares a lot about the fan base. So I think that they've got a lot of...
He actually listens!
Yeah, I think that they've got everything that they need as far as support is to, like, help spread the word for something. Like, I don't know. I think they're doing really well. So I have a lot of faith in them and their decisions. So there's that.
Thanks for joining me, everybody. It's a nice little chat. It's been a while since we've had just one of these laid-back podcasts since, like, we kind of stopped the monthly terror.
Been practically a year.
It's been a while.
Perfectly, yeah.
If you guys listening to this enjoy this kind of format and want to see more, like, sort of opinion trash-talking podcasts, then let us know. Especially if you have topics you'd like us to talk about, then that would, like, be great. to like give us some direction there, because we're not sure what to do with this kind of thing. It's just we figured there was a lot to talk about right now, so we made a podcast about it. But yeah, just
when Aspie said we were going to talk some shit, he wasn't kidding.
Yeah, lots of opinions thrown around today.
Lots of opinions.
But yeah, just like let us know in the comments below what you think, and we'll be sure to read all of those and respond accordingly. So yeah, stay tuned. We have the Love Song Book Club coming up very soon and some podcasts for that. It's going to be awesome fun. And that should tie us over until Little Bus is released on Steam. So catch you later, guys.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, boo.
Bye.
We'll be right back.